My full name is Christine Roberta Olson Harp, and I was born on June the 22nd, 1925. I was born in Cleveland, Ohio. I had a difficult childhood because of my father's attack of arthritis when I was only about 4 or 5 years old. And that caused the family to have to be separated. And it meant that although I was born in Cleveland, Ohio, now that my mother had to come east to Hagerstown with her family, and my father was in the hospital in Cleveland, and so we were separated family for a while. I went to, of course, elementary school. We didn't have preschool in those days. Into middle school and high school, I went to a very small high school in Western Maryland. It was called Smithsburg High School. And the year that my sister Lucille graduated was the year that an FBI agent came to Smithsburg, of all places. Why did he come? I don't understand that. But anyway, it was wartime and they were looking for employees. And so Lucille, my sister, signed up to work in the FBI right out of high school. And that was a big stretch from a small community in Smithsburg to going into Washington, D.C. And of course, it was safe because it was wartime and the men were most of them were in the war, and the FBI experience was it expanded your whole experience in life. It really stretched, gave us experience of what it was like to live in a city, and to go to a larger church and shop in their fantastic department stores. It was amazing. In the FBI, we had a chance to meet the director, J. Edgar Hoover. He would take in a few employees in his office and give us a picture. And they also provided events around the city so that you got acquainted with some of the places around D.C., the Mount Vernon and I've forgotten other places, Quantico, and so that you could sign up and go with a group, and then you learn to know more about the area around Washington. I was just an ordinary, you'd call it, the clerk. In those days, whenever mail was received by the FBI, any name that appeared in the correspondence would be underlined, and they'd make up a card with that name and refer you to the document where the name appeared. And there was an area, the whole floor of one of the buildings that had nothing but card filing system where all these names would be filed, and I was a clerk with other clerks who learned to file. I have in my index my original card where I would identify the drawer that I was working in, had my name on it, and I still have that in my index. I met Mark Wood, we always called him Mark, when I was about to graduate from Towson State Teachers College. And I met him at the local church youth program. He came and attended, and I was attending, and that's where I met him. So we knew each other just several weeks, because when I graduated, I went back to Hagerstown and he was still in Towson. So I was gone all that summer. And then the plan was for me to come back to Baltimore County and begin teaching. And so that's when we renewed our acquaintance. And since I was older and he was older, he was 25 and I was 27, and we had a very short courtship and were engaged in just a few months. And so it was, I guess, love at first sight, I don't know. We were married in March of 1951, I think. Was it 51 or 52? I think it was 52. I came back to Lock Raven Elementary School where I taught fourth grade. I only taught a short time because I found out that the first year of teaching was very difficult for me, and I was also getting married and trying to set up a household, so I didn't teach very long. My husband Mark and I renovated three properties, and that's quite a challenge, to renovate three properties. It takes a lot of patience and working together and waiting. The biggest project was the 408 Stevenson Lane house, which took us over 38 years. We bought that property because it was a two-apartment house. And even though it was in bad condition, we figured that since Mark had no retirement from the family business, that we could renovate and rent part of it as a source of income. So that's what we worked toward for 38 years, and we were able to improve it and upgrade it, and we did have on the second floor in the back a rental apartment. So that was, although it was difficult, it was very satisfying to see the progress, even though it was slow, to see the progress over the years, and we were able to improve it to the place where our granddaughter had such good memories, one of our granddaughters, of being there, that she wanted to live there, and now she lives in that house. So that's an amazing thing, and it's very satisfying to know that we brought this place from the ashes almost up into the place where it became desirable. There's a dream. The property was bought in 1940. Granddad Maynard and Retta, whenever they were able, they purchased more acreage until it reached the size, was it 80 acres or 70? Forgotten. They used this property as a summer getaway from their Stoneley residence. No one ever lived in this house all winter until John and his family used it for a while. Then in 2008, Mark and I decided we would sell our Stevenson Lane home and renovate the Maywood house to make it a year-round house, which meant that it had to be insulated, and we added a small addition, so it has become a year-round dwelling. I have taken on later in life, when the family was older, I took on childcare. And I did that, and then as an older person, the Central Presbyterian Church asked if I would take on the responsibility of assistant treasurer, and it was a volunteer job, and they had learned that I had worked in the family business, Maynard E. Harp and Son, and for some reason they thought perhaps I could. So I took on the job of assistant treasurer at Central Presbyterian Church, and I worked at that job for over 10 years. The daily routine is taking time to get up and to get myself moving, and I have a breathing problem which is very frustrating that I have to work around. And so it takes me a while to get my breathing normal so that I can then start to move around. So it takes me a while to get up, and then I, when I'm ready, I go into the kitchen and get my breakfast. And I take my time because of my breathing problem and not being able to walk very well. And so it's it can be 10 or 10:30, maybe even 11 o'clock before I finish breakfast. So then after breakfast and after I clean up a little bit in the kitchen, then I have to rest. So then I rest, catch my breath, and then I try to remind myself that I have to walk a certain amount of time every day to keep mobile. So then I spend time walking and trying to drink enough water. And then it's the time that I try to do some responsibilities, like bill paying and filing the documents and doing the dishes in the kitchen, and just taking care of other household duties. I have Merry Maids coming every 2 weeks, so I don't do any cleaning, but they keep the house clean. But there are other little tasks that I perform to keep things in order. I like to do my word seek puzzles, and I like to do the adult coloring with the colored pencils. And the puzzle that I have on the kitchen table, I enjoy. I like to be outside, and it makes it hard in the winter because the cold air isn't good to my breathing, so I have to limit my time outside during cold weather. But in the summer, I'd like to be out on the porches as much as possible. And I used to enjoy so much working on the property, just doing small things. But since it's difficult and gets more difficult for me to walk and manage the breathing, I'm not able to do anything on the property anymore, which is a disappointment. And I like to work outside. Well, another thing I am very happy about is that my husband and I were very careful about the task of raising our children. And at a very young age, we would have family devotions, and as soon as they were old enough, they each had their own Bible. And although we didn't do it strictly on a strict schedule, we always had occasions to have devotions together where we would read the scripture and we would pray together, and the children would hear mother and father pray at a very early age. So all of our children have become believers and have continued through their adult life, and I feel that that's been a great blessing. I'm very grateful for where I am in life. It's in a way been a difficult road. Everybody has their difficulties, but now I am a place that's quiet and peaceful, enjoyable, and I'm very grateful for the way things have turned out. I got a mind.